his job is still safe. We don't know whether that will still be the same case if he loses tomorrow, but they have to be very competitive tomorrow. All they need is a draw. I see a very negative game tomorrow. Nothing high on excitement. They will just do the barest minimum to see them over the line.
How many English teams do you see crossing that line?
Well, City are through already. They should be joined by Chelsea. Those are the only certainties as far as I'm concerned. Just City, and I think Chelsea will also go through as well. Arsenal, miracles do happen.
Is it that bad?
It's not bad.
They've lost a lot of impetus. They've lost a lot of more than a lot of head of steam. So it will take a lot from them tomorrow if they can get the results tomorrow.
Tolu, quickly run through. This is what we're going to see tomorrow in the UEFA Champions League. Tolu, can you quickly run us through what we have on screen?
Bayer Leverkusen against Barcelona at the Bay Arena. This game will definitely guarantee goals if you saw the two fixtures between Bayern Leverkusen and Roma, home and away. And then Roma taking on Bate Borisov in Rome at the Stadio Olimpico. Dinamo Zagreb against Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich damaged and ruined Dinamo Zagreb's unbeaten record in the previous fixture. Ended 5-0. Olympiacos against Arsenal is the big game we talked about earlier. Chelsea against FC Porto is another must not lose game for Chelsea. Dynamo Kiev against Maccabi Tel Aviv. Maccabi Tel Aviv have not won a single game. They have 0 points as far as I'm concerned. And the Dynamo need a win to go through. And hopefully, Chelsea or Porto, one team will win for Dynamo to go through in that game. Gent has done the impossible so far this season. Their first year in the UEFA Champions League, and they've picked wins and are on the verge of doing the unthinkable.
Absolutely.
Should they win in Zenit, in St. Petersburg against Zenit?
Yeah.
At home against Zenit St. Petersburg, they will qualify.
Yeah.
While Valencia, Gary Neville has a tough
first
job.
Game in charge.
He needs to win this game
fire,
and hope that Gent don't win.
All right.
I think he should win. Lyon haven't been particularly good this season.
Yeah.
Losing at home to Angers by 2 goals.
All right, let's go back to this. We have to go back to this. We're not apologists, but we just have to highlight that Manchester United had a goal disallowed. One matter scored.
You know, you previously said it was 2-2. It was currently 2-2. Mm-hmm. Apparently, that goal by Juan Mata has been disallowed.
So
going into halftime, it's still Wolfsburg leading Manchester United by
2-1. All games at halftime.
Plenty of
as we speak,
sweating United fans all over the world. Hoping that
Thursday night football.
Yeah.
Okay.
Looming.
Okay. That's the update for you. Manchester United trailing. But well, 45 minutes of football still to be played, and so we'll see what happens, guys. In a minute, let me allow you to talk about Neymar. Does it come as a surprise to you that the Brazilian captain is voted? Well, some people will say in the absence of Lionel Messi, he's not been playing, just got back. You know, does it come to you as a surprise?
The surprise
the
is actually
rise, the rise. A lot of people have started comparing the stats of Neymar that look, even the burden of Barcelona can't be carried by the Brazilian. You shouldn't depend on Messi as much as you used to. I mean, a lot of accolades coming in the way of the Brazilian, and I'm wondering if it's just hype.
Not hype. I thought the young man earned the praise. I thought he's done so well in 2015. The showboating is he entertains and he delivers. He's a player who has shown that, look, you can equally depend on me. I carry the Brazilian national team, the Selecao. It is not easy over there. And then,
debatable. You know, there's always been that argument that he never really brings it for Brazil the same way he brings it for Barcelona. You can argue that
the quality of the team is different. When you have Iniesta playing behind you, it's different from
when Rakitic, you have Sergio Busquets, you also have plenty of you also have Luis Suarez, who's equally hardworking.
It's
Alves, Jordi Alba. It's unbelievable.
And it's surprising that he's the first Barcelona player to win the
award.
That is the surprise.
For me. Not the fact that he won the award. The fact that he was actually the first Barcelona player
in
to actually win the award. So there's some kind of ridiculous politics going on in Spanish football. So I wouldn't really read too much into this. But the surprise was the fact that he won. But there's no surprise because, really, he's deserving of it. He's had a phenomenal past 8 weeks in the absence of Lionel Messi. Has done a tremendous amount of work alongside Luis Suarez. So congratulations to the young man.
Okay, so you don't believe all those accolades, all the encomiums, everything
well deserved.
Well deserved. Okay.
Well deserved.
All right. We need to go on a break and leave football unless there's an update to give to you. We also allow Tolu go and have a rest. When we come back, Julian Ajumwa joins us. We'll be taking a look at other things happening in the exciting world of sports as concerns Nigerians, talking about tennis, table tennis that is, talking about wrestling, and a whole lot more for you on Sports Night. We're going on a break. We'll allow you listening to Rafael Nadal, his plans for 2016. Join us again.
We're going to be back to winning Grand Slams now and working hard to create opportunities to compete for the best tournaments, and I am working so hard to try to make that happen. No, I think it's obvious that I didn't have the best season possible, but I finished at number 5 in the world. No, so actually it's not a disaster. No, number 5 in the world is a good number too, and I hope to be ready for the beginning of next season to play at the right level. No, I think I finished it very well this season, and I want to continue with that. I am not Federer, no. I am Rafael Nadal, and he has his style. I have my own style. I for sure try to improve my things during all my career, and for sure I'm working hard to be better player. No, and if I am better player, for sure I'm gonna have the chance to play a little bit longer. No, so I'm working so hard to improve.
All right, welcome back. Well, 2015 wasn't really good for Rafael Nadal, but of course he's planning to come back strong in 2016. He's told us not to compare him with Roger Federer. He's his own man, and of course he promises to come back stronger in 2016, and of course probably win more Grand Slams in 2016. Okay, let's move on the show. Let's talk about wrestling. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but somebody has to do it anyway. Just to tell you that we told you about our wrestlers that were planning to go for a tournament in Brazil, but the news is that because of funds, they are not able to make it. We were supposed to go with 11 wrestlers, but that didn't happen. It's really a sad one. A lot of good things have been happening to our wrestlers in recent times, but this one just comes as a rude shock, really. And I allow the guys to talk about it. I'm not feeling good about it. But Julian joins us now. And on that sober note, I'd like to welcome you talking about the wrestlers. Really, when we've been talking about wrestlers in recent times, the Federation president doing a lot to ensure that, look, things are going on well. The athletes getting top quality competitions to participate in. But this one just, you know, it leaves a sore taste in your mouth, really.
Yeah, I think it's a very sad one at this point. You know, you want to say it's always the stuff that happens right here in Nigeria. Athletes mm-hmm. failing to participate in major tournaments owing to issue of funds. And I mean, it's very sad. As an athlete, they will want to participate, but knowing mm-hmm. fully well that funds are not available for them to participate, I think it's not just the best for them. But it's something that must be sorted out, at least to avoid the future reoccurrence.
Today, what do you say? I mean, you can't practice in isolation.
No, you cannot. And I don't know. It's just a lot of people will be very quick to blame the government, mm-hmm. but you must understand that they cannot do everything. We are fighting tremendous economic challenges at home. Mm-hmm. The economy is probably in a recession right now. A few years ago, oil was selling at $147, $150 a barrel. Now it's selling for $37 a barrel. So you can imagine the tremendous shortfall in finances that the government is also experiencing. The private sector that is also supposed to shoulder part of this burden are also currently facing tremendous challenges as well. People are being laid off. Salaries cannot be paid. So you're expecting them to sponsor sporting activities, they will tell you it is the least of their priorities right now. So it's just unfortunate that a sport like wrestling is being caught in the crossfire due to no fault of theirs mm-hmm. because of economic upheavals everywhere. I'm just hoping that the sports minister will take it upon himself. If this is the only legacy that he can leave for Nigerian sports, it will leave his footprints in the sand of time. Let us look at ways in which our sporting associations can be properly funded in order to ensure that they can run sustainable programs throughout the year and not depend on government for everything. And they want it's done in other countries, and they do it successfully. Why we cannot do it, I still fail to understand. We've mentioned here before how Special Olympics Nigeria run their programs devoid of any form of government input, and they do it successfully. So if Special Olympics can do it. What about the able-bodied, yeah, federation? You know, federation?